that one.
Getting close now. Head for that ridge.
Good. I can use this.
The tall neck's just over this ridge. You'll see it when you reach the top. Now be ready to act fast. You need to get in and get it done before they raise an alarm. Here we go.
You getting this? I see the legs of a tall neck down there, but no tall neck.
Damn. The transmitter's been moved. Check down the ravine to the left. Only place it could be.
So much for your insider knowledge. Toward the explosions. Great.
You got exactly one shot at this, Aloy, so spare the sarcasm and make it count. You see that bridge over the ravine?
Yep.
Memorize its location. There's a rappel point on the side. That'll be your way out.
And these eclipse troopers?
Avoid them, or kill them, your choice. The blasting should cover any noise you make. Find the tall neck and destroy the module on top.
Here we go.
Food. Adam's good enough for the rest of us. It's good enough for him.
Walking the sun all day to serve the chef.
Let it end like this! Fight!
So long as you're quick, it won't affect you.
Oh, good. Another secret. What is this place?
A distraction.
There are several data points.
So long as King Itamen languishes at sunfall, coddled by his mother, he will never learn the true lessons of the sun. I have tried to instruct him, but the shadow of his mother's influence is upon him. I took him to the palace balcony to behold an offering of sacrifice in the ring. But he showed no thirst for it. He averted his gaze. Look to the sun, I told him. Do not shield your eyes. In all things, it is absolute. One day, it nurtures life, and the next scorches life away. It burns the skin of champions and wretches alike. Never does the sun show pity. That is the example a Sun King must follow.
A mural of Meridian and the Spire.
When sleep refuses to come, I think of our wedding night. How you welcomed me to the marital bed. How after, when you fell asleep, I lay there watching your delicate face. For all its beauty, I detested its fragility. A rage swelled up inside me. I abhorred that bed, how its softness threatened to swallow us up. And that room, the stench of incense, the fine embroidery of the drapes, all of it weak. I slipped from the bed, threw open the casement, and lay naked on the stone floor, determined to spurn all seductions of comfort. But when I woke the next morning, you lay beside me, naked as I in the cold. Your body, stretched beside mine, seemed chiseled from stone. I saw you wake, instantly alert, like an animal ready to strike. You said nothing. You did not have to. Already you had shown me beyond doubt that we were meant to be. Never does the sun show pity. And yet, when my wife died in birthing, and in dying ended the life of my child unborn, I pitied myself. My lord sensed this, but instead of casting me down for weakness, he cast upon me a radiant beam of honor. He ordered my kin buried in the sacred caves reserved for royals and heroes. Unimaginable. Never again would I doubt that I am the chosen of the sun. Never again would pity find a place in me. Not for myself or another. When I first set eyes on the buried shadow, I trembled. Was I not the chosen of the sun? A blazing light of faith to shred and scatter darkness? Was it not my place to destroy this devil? But High Priest Bahavas instructed me in the prophecy and set right my frame of mind. The murder of the true Sun King broke the cosmic cycle short of completion. The whole world cast into darkness, doomed. To resume and turn the wheel of time would require more than sun and faith. All forces must combine, all halves of nature join to one cause. Shadow to sun, night to day. Even a buried shadow wants the wheel to turn, for without a sun in the sky, there can be no shadow. My lord, the 13th king of the Karja Sundom was murdered. Cut down by cowards who mistook firm rule for madness. Ever the strong are beset upon by the weak. So he said, as the traitors launched their assault. As their cannons forged by Oseram filth toppled the battlements and burst the gates. I would have fought to the end. But it was his will, the will of the sun, that I lead the prince and queen into the west, to safety. My lord did not hesitate. He saw his fate. He looked into the sun, and he did not blink. With me, he sent kestrels, nobles, sun priests, and slaves. Killing all that stood in the way, I carved a path to sunfall. There, we joined others to gather the strength to take back our home. But our our strength only faded until the buried shadow was brought to light. Every morning, I wake to the same nightmare. The same reality. Holy Meridian in the hands of profligates. Debased. The spire, towering above the horizon like in a glittering spike through the center of my mind. Every daybreak in exile is a mark of failure. But the count of days runs thin. I will see Meridian retaken, the profligates slaughtered, a true king restored to the Mesa throne. In this, I have become an instrument of prophecy.
He's a fanatic, all right. Single-minded.
It gives him a focus that you seem to lack. Now, how about finding that Tallneck?
It would not have been easy to drag the Tallneck down his path. Why bother?
Just find it and get to the top. Destroy the module, and then get out fast as you can.
Sure is a lot of blasting up there. Sounds busy.
Busy enough not to notice you, let's hope.
Kind of struck.
Alert. Irregular transmission source detected.
The module.
Good. Now be quick.
This is Hades?
Eloy, this is not the time.
It's a metal devil.
Open the module's casing now. Aloy, do as I say or all is lost.
That was easy.
running!
Brave trail. Yeah, you think? What do you think I'm doing? Taking a nap?
Keep moving!
Are you kidding me?
Don't fight. Keep moving.
What?
Head left towards the camp.
Got it. Almost there.
Get ready for that shadow.
Yeah, I noticed.
More cliffs across the ravine.
Bridge in sight.
That's the way out.
I know.
Rough going, but you survived.
You knew Hades was there, and you sent me to him?
I won't deny I risked your life, but it was the only way. Now, with the Focus Network down, we can both get what we want. Access to the secrets of Zero Dawn.
I'm past trusting you with secrets.
Good. That means you're wising up. Trust is for fools. It shifts and crumbles like sand. A poor foundation for any partnership. But mutual self-interest. Now that is a solid bedrock upon which you and I might build a new science of understanding. We both need answers, Aloy. And thanks to you, we're on the verge of grasping them. At Sunfall, we'll speak again.
You miserable...